Me, Terry Kay. Now, a couple of quick notes. If any breweries have sent me beers and I've been, you know, a long time kind of sorting them out, it's because I've got such a backlog. You know, a lot of breweries nowadays are sending me beers, and you know, I want to make sure that I do the right job with them. And unfortunately, it takes time, you know, but I'm gonna show you one here, and one of the things that I'm gonna show you is these guys have got the best, the very best back labels I've ever seen. I think they've been listening to yours truly. I hope so, because this is almost what I described. It's almost what I've wanted, you know. If you look at the back of this, it's the Big Ben. This is from Thwaites Brewery. It's got taste notes, and it says taste notes above it. So you go, hold on. If you don't want to listen to taste notes, you read immediately the taste notes, you go, all right, I'll skip that section. Or if you want to know what it's about, you know, if you don't know what a beer's like and you're buying it for someone, or you know, I don't want to know what a beer's like, because it's like watching a film, you know, it's like, you know, watching, say, The Ghost The Sixth Sense. It's like watching The Sixth Sense and then going, by the way, did you know Bruce Willis was the ghost? And you go, oh, for fuck, what? Why'd you tell me that? You just ruined, you know, Star Wars, did you know that Darth Vader is his dad? What? Why did you tell me that? That sort of thing, you know. And did you know that the murderer was in the end, you know, The Usual Suspects? Did you know it was Verbal Kent? Did you know he was, so. I'm sorry, but taste notes for me, that is taste notes. It's like I want to try a beer and I want to be surprised by it. I want the film, you know, I want the beer to tell me the story of the beer and not the label to say, by the way, the murderer was don't tell anyone else. And you kind of go, why the bloody hell should I drink it then? You know, I can also see why they needs to be put on there. I can see that. There's 30% of me can see that, and then there's 80% of me. 80% of me says, no, please don't put it on there. But look, they've clearly marked it. But that, how important is this? Oh, so important, I think. Put list of the hops, list of the malts, list of the yeasts, and whatever else you're using. Look, Fuggles, Goldings, all these sort of things. You put them on them and you go, Fuggles, Goldings, Challenger. Straight away you go, that's kind of Fullersy like, those combinations. And then you go, Citra, Chinook. Hold on, now you're getting different things. Now you're getting kind of in the realms of, you're getting like the triple C's in it. You know, you're cutting the Challenger, Chinook, and Citra. But with a Citra, you've got that like lovely, fruity. And you're getting Chinook, also nice and fruity hops. And you're getting some as well. You'll get to learn these hops. Especially in single hop beers and things. You'll get, lovely. Now, certain single hop beers, they put them on, you know, like First Gold. They'll put it on the thing. They'll actually call it a title, like Shepherd Neame First Gold. And you go, right, let's taste what First Gold is like. and first golden rule through the brew, that little miniature hop, you kind of go, right, now I've tasted it, I'll recognise that, and you recognise it in different ones. Suddenly you taste a different one, you go, I've had that before, where? And if you've had thousands of beers, you kind of go, like that, you know, it is difficult, but if you've had just, you know, that first gold just a little while ago, you go, I remember it now. That was the one I had just a little while ago in that single hop beer. And the thing, same thing goes with all sorts of hops and everything else. Mikella do a single hop varieties. There's a few others do. I think Mikella's also got, at the moment, going on, one I'm deeply interested in, is a, the one that they use, the same recipes, and all they change is yeast. I so want to see that. I so want them. Right, the yeast that they use in this is Thwaites Ale yeast. They've got Pale Ale and Crystal Malt. Crystal Malt gives you a bit of sweetness, a bit of sugariness. Crystal, reason why they call it Crystal Malt is that it's slightly stewed, and when it dries, little crystals of sugar appear that shine off the floor in the light and that, you know. Craft then is Daniel Thwaites, blah 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 blah. Right, there's not else on there. Recipe LBA 14, which is good. I've gone a long way into it, I haven't opened it. Right, so I'm gonna really try to crack away quickly. Plain black. Right, so I'm crashing away at this. I don't think we're talking a lot of sediment. I'm going to go that way. Stop it there. Oh, lovely. But very burgundy. Dark burgundy. That's what I'm telling you about. You can't see it from your side. But dark burgundy, you can see the tan, sort of light tan head. You can't smell the blood orange. You can't smell the blood orange again. And you can't smell the tangerines and physalis and navel orange. There's all sorts of orange. There's blood orange, big blood orange. You also can't smell sharp, almost. Not quite unripe cherries, but certainly something with a bit of bounce to them. There's cherries in there with a bit of, quite a bit of bounce. Really beautiful. Right, cheers everyone. Oh, that's interesting. That is subtle, subtle, mild and subtle. Not what you expect. When you get the bugle on it, when you get the nose on it, it's really weird. Because on the nose, you're expecting all sorts of stuff going on. When you taste it, it's mild, subtle, almost chocolatey. That is weird. It's almost slightly chocolatey, slightly fruity chocolatey, like a cherry chocolate or something like that. But it's not overpoweringly cherry. That is a weird one. It really is. But I like it. I do like it. Oh, it's a strange one though. Right. What does it taste like? What I had this at the GBBF. And I don't think it tastes anything similar even. From what I had at the GBBF, this is a completely different drink. It's still really lovely. But it's a completely different, really completely different drink. Pardon me. Yeah. It's not the same beer at all. But I'm thinking, it's beautiful. It really is beautiful. You really have got to try it and bite and like it without doubt. But I'll try it, bite and love it. But that is nothing like cask. Cask Big Ben and the bottle Big Ben are totally different. And they are not just, not even just slightly different. They are so different that they are a different beer. Completely a different beer. There's no there's similarities, I suppose. But, certainly some similarities. But it's like saying, well, look, this cherry, it's comparing a cherry with an orange, you know. There's very little similarities. That's not, let's pour the yeast in. Right, what we got? Very little. Almost a slight tobacco note in the background. But you've got a nice little cherry note in there. Cherry note's pretty. He is pretty. And he's in there. Definitely a cherry note. But he's struggling. Everything else I should say is struggling. And I don't know. Try it, bite and like it, I think. That the bottle, try it, bite and love it. But if you've had it on cask, don't expect the same thing in bottle, because it's absolutely wildly different. So if you've had it on cask and or on bottle and expecting the same drink from cask, they're different. They're so different. They're like not chalk and cheese. They're chalk and chools or some whatever. You know, there's nothing similar about them. Anyway, chin chin, bottoms up, and stuff like that. And I'm going, have I missed anything like that? If I do miss anything, let me know, because my mind goes a-wandering. As you can see from this year, I've had brain damage and stuff like that, motor accident and stuff like that, and time frames and whatever else. Luckily, I can still learn things. They are a bit more difficult to learn. I have to go over and over and over and over and over. But when it comes to things like beer, going over and over stuff is great. And also, there are rewards to having a brain that goes wandering. You know, it's certain things that I'll get a beer that I've had before, you know. And whereas you've had a beer and you go, oh, I didn't like that one, or, you know, this was really nice and it was such a surprising beer, and I'll sort of would have forgot about it. And I'll get a beer and I'll go, got to try this one or whatever, you know. Or must try this one. You know, let's give it a go. I wonder what it's like, you know, and I've already tried it. And I go, oh, right. And I'll try it out again and go, oh, I really like that. I've already tried it and said the same thing or similar things. Yeah, so that's how my brain works. But stick with it. You know, as you can see, it's sawn up and smashed up, and my head's been full, smashed, and the skull's been in, and God knows what else. It's a wonder that I'm actually still walking and talking. Because I had to learn to do both. And sometimes you will see me very drunk and you won't even know it. And you'll see me, other times you'll see me completely sober. Not even a touch of the first drink of the night. And I'll be going, anyway, I said, you know, I'll be all over the place. My vocal slur and everything else. So, sorry, I shouldn't go that far and carry on, but I'm just looking the next beer up, because sometimes I do 3 or 4 on a trot. But anyway, if you're ever wondering how I do actually act under 4 or 5 beers, look at some of the festival reviews. Anyway, see you soon. Take care. Absolutely joy chatting to you guys and girls. See you next one. Don't be late. I'll start with there. Billy Boo. Bye.